Good morning, students of class 6. Today we are going to begin with a new chapter, that is chapter number 5, sorting materials. So let's start with part 1 of this chapter. In our everyday life, we come across many instances where we need to arrange the things into different groups or into different categories. For example, when we go to the library, we can see the books arranged in a particular order. Your library ma'am may ask you to put a certain book in a certain category only. Now, can you see various things on this particular page? If I ask you to arrange or sort the things in one particular group, then how are you going to do it? Let's see. You will group the spoon, the plate, and the glass in one category because they all belong to the kitchen. Then you will group the biscuit and pasta together because these two are eatables. And you will group the books and the pencil in another group because both of these are stationery. So what is classification or sorting? Classification or sorting can be defined as the process of putting things or certain materials in particular group or category. Material is a substance that is used to make different kind of objects. And objects are made up of one or more materials. For example, a pencil is made up of wood as well as your graphite lid. Then one material can be used to make different types of object. For example, glass can be used to make mirror, as well as glass can be also used to make various types of vessels. Now let us learn about some of the properties based on which the materials can be grouped or classified. They are luster, texture, hardness, state, solubility, flotation, magnetic property, conductivity, and transparency. Starting with the first property, that is luster. Luster can be defined as the property or a quality of a material to shine. Based on luster, there are two categories of materials: lustrous materials and non-lustrous materials. Materials that are shiny in appearance are known as lustrous materials. And on the other hand, the materials that are dull in appearance or those that lack shine are known as non-lustrous materials. Some lustrous materials may lose their shine and appear dull when they are exposed to moisture for longer duration. As you can see in the picture, there is a rusted chain. So this is a process of rusting where iron reacts with the moisture and oxygen present in the air. So they lose their shine. Gold, silver, steel, and iron are some examples of lustrous materials, while wood, wool, and rubber are some of the examples of non-lustrous materials. What do you think will happen when you rub lustrous materials with a sandpaper? In case if the lustrous material has lost its shine due to deposition of some substance on it, then rubbing with a sandpaper will help in removal of that top layer and hence will make the material shiny again. Now moving on to the next property based on which the materials are grouped together, that is texture. Texture can be defined as the feel of a substance when it is touched. Now, based on texture, the materials can be divided into two categories, that is rough materials and smooth materials. Rough materials are stone, wood, body scrubbers, sandpaper, and skin of pineapple. While on the other hand, the examples of smooth materials are cotton, wool, silk, sponge, and soft toys. Now our next property is hardness. Hardness is that property or the quality of any substance to resist Compression means how much you can press that particular substance. Again, on the basis of hardness, materials can be grouped into two different categories. Materials can be hard or they can be soft. Materials that can be easily compressed or easily pressed are called as soft materials, for example, wool, cotton, sponge, and foam. On the other hand, the materials that are difficult to compress are known as hard materials, for example, wood, stone, and hard plastic. That's all for today. Tomorrow we will be back with some more properties for sorting materials. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.